Hello guys, welcome back to the Don't Hack channel. Well, this is Christian and I'm going to walk you through how you can connect your MongoDB to your Next.js and also build some queries upon that, right? So this module is going to be an interesting one. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button if you haven't and join this community. Right, so let's start. So I've already created my projects, right? But then don't worry, I'm going to show you how you can also create yours. And once you are done, you can move on. So open your command prompt. All right, and in your command prompt, navigate to the directory you want to create your Next.js application. So for mine, I will save it to my desktop. And then inside my desktop, I'll create my project here, right? So how you can create this project is to type in npx, right? Create spacebar, sorry, dash, next spacebar app, right? Once you're done, you can add in the project name, right? So project name. Mind you, the project name is supposed to be in lowercase, not uppercase. Once you're done, you can press enter. So once you press enter, it's going to create this project for you right here. It's a beautiful project. And inside this project, we have the next folder, we have the models folder, we have the pages. This is where you are going to do our backend stuff, right? So let's start. So we have to first connect our MongoDB to our backend, right? So which you have to connect the MongoDB server so that when this app is running, it can listen to any post you make or request you do, right? So in this directory, I want us to create a new folder, which I'm going to call it utils, right? And in this util, we are going to create a file. In this file, let's name it connect MongoDB, right? Let me capitalize the m.jx, right? So this is where you are going to create it. So we are going to need mongos, so you can open your terminal and let's install our mongos. So mong npm iphone install, or you can type it in full and then mongos, right? Once you are done, press enter. It's going to install mongos for you. I've already done that, so I'm not going to install it again. All right, so once you are done installing, let's import our mongos. So import mongos, right? Oh, why mongos from mongos, right? And I think the naming convention has changed. Okay, let's leave it as default. And then here, let's create our mongoose. So connect, I'm going to call it connect db, right? And it's an async function. So then it's going to be connect, right? And then you pass in the path, and the path is mongodb forward slash. We need a column before the forward slash, and then localhost, and then the port is not going to be for 3000 or 5000, but then the default port MongoDB gives to us is 27017, right? And then now the name we want to give to our database is going to be, let's say, DB demo, right? This is the name we want to give to our database once it's being created on our machine locally. So after that, what we are going to do is we are going to export, right? So export default and then connect db. So we are going to export this and then use it forever, right? So we've set up our MongoDB connection. So we can now go ahead and create models, and then inside it you can use it to generate queries for this application. You want to build a simple school system, maybe you can, 3 models will be enough, right? So don't worry, stick with me. So inside the main directory again, I want us to create another folder. We're going to call it models, and inside this model I would like us to create a subject model, because you are building a simple school system, right? So let's type subject .js, right? And inside here we are going to create our model. So we are going to import our schema, our model, and then models. I'll tell you what you're going to use the models for, don't worry. So first of all, let's create our schema. I'm going to call it subject schema. Right, I'm going to create schema out of it. So schema. Okay, in this subject schema, I want to give it a name, right? And then probably a level. So name is going to be of type string, and then it's supposed to be required. So required is supposed to be true. And then let's think this is enough for the name, and then the level is going to be a number, right? So that one, let's leave it for now. Maybe you can make it required or not. I would like to keep it as it is. And then right here, I would like to create the model out of it. So const, now call it subject, right? And then we are going to create our model as we know. So we are going to pass in the name subject, right? So now let's type in the name of the schema. So it's going to be subject schema, right? So now we can export it. So export default, sorry, keep on typing the bag, and then subject, right? Oops. So subject, yeah. So but then you've realized I didn't use the models, right? Why did I import the model? What I want to do is, I don't want to keep on creating the model every single time you run this application. You get me? So what you are going to do is, the models, you are going to take the models and tap into the models and check if you have the subject model being created already. If it's been created already, then you are going to save that into the subject and then export it. But then if it's not already been created, then we are going to create it using this one. So we are going to tap into the models subject or create, do you get me? Right, so now we are good to go. I don't want us to spend much time, but then I would like to give you a try. You can pause the video and then try it for me, right? So I want us to create a class, right? And then the class is going to take, it's going to have the field for class name, and then let's say the subjects in the class, and then probably anything you want to add. But then I want you to look at what we've done here and then create a class module. Okay, so once you are done, and then I'm going to also do mine, right? So once you are done, just wait and let me do mine. And then so let's say inside the models, I'm going to call another, say class.js, right? So I'm going to import my schema, then my model, then my model. Alright, so this is how it is, right? And then we are going to do what? Tell me something, okay? So we are going to create our schema. So we are going to say class schema, right? And then we are going to give it the schema. Alright, so inside the schema, I would like to give it a class name. So let me see, class name, right? Let me give it a type of string. Alright, and it's supposed to be required. So it's required, true, right? And then I want to give it another, so subjects. And then mind you, the subjects, I want it to contain the foreign key. So subject ID, so I want the foreign key to be here, you get me? And then also we are going to add another field to it if you want. So before we can add a foreign key to this one, mind you, MongoDB is not restricted to it, allows you to make a query any way you want, right? So let's import our module we created, which is the subject module. So import, so once you type subject, you can import the module from subject, right, and use it right here. So I'm going to create another field called subject. Oh, subject ID, which is going to contain the ID of, so it's going to be a type of, let's say, schema dot object, right? You're going to tap into the object of this schema. So object ID,